In this video, we're going to skip all the introductory stuff and get right to it. If you need more details on using Ethernet IP on the Productivity 3000, check out these videos. They provide a lot more background and introductory information. We want the 8 analog inputs from the Savantec Remote I/O device to be transferred to the Productivity 3000 in the background using the Ethernet IP I/O messaging. Setting up this module is just like setting up any other Ethernet IP scanner on the Productivity 3000. You just double-click on Hardware Configuration and click on the Ethernet IP tab. Here you can see the digital I/O module we set up in a previous video. To add the analog module, we just drop a new generic client on the screen. I went ahead and filled in all the usual status tags and entered the IP address of my Atom 6117. Down here, everything's the same as the previous videos. Except for this device, we created an input array with 8 16-bit words to accept the 8 channels of analog data from the Atom device. We also need to tell it to send us all 8 channels. Over in the output window, I created an 8-channel array just because I had to put something there, and we'll go ahead and put an 8 here, even though we're not really sending any data. Over in the configuration window, it's the exact same thing as before. Again, created a dummy array, but we're not going to send any data with that array. And since I had already created all of the tags, the software didn't ask us to verify all the new tags we created. But we do want to go back in and hit that monitor button so we can create a data view for this new analog module. Great, that's it. All we have to do now, download this project to the controller, and we're ready to go. Let's bring up that data view, enable this new module, the 6117EI we just created. Our connection was successful. We are connected to the device. The other fields got filled in. Perfect. That's exactly what we wanted to see. Now that the device is enabled, that data is being transferred in the background between the Atom device and the Productivity 3000. Let's take a look at it. Here's all of our input channels. Well, almost all of them. Where's the last one? There it is. And I have a potentiometer hooked up to input number 8. If I rotate that potentiometer, sure enough, you see the values track. And remember, there is no ladder code yet. This is all happening in the background automatically. The data is just sitting there, ready for my ladder code to use. That's sweet. Now let me show you a trick. If you go up into the data view options and enable graphing, so I'll say OK. Now look what I can do. I can take that input and I can hit the graph. And when I do that, I get a running graph over here of that analog input. So as I change the value, you can see it change on the graph. If you right click on the signal, you can enable or disable that signal, change the color, get a little color palette here. Let's change it to red and change the format and everything. And there you go. These little arrows right here allow for quick adjustments. I can go wide on just the data, bring back the graph, or go full screen on the graph, just like that. So those little arrows are pretty handy. Well, that's all there is to using this analog input module with the Productivity 3000 and Ethernet IP. Check out the other videos in this series for more tips on using Ethernet IP with the Productivity 3000. And don't forget, Automation Direct's award-winning support is always free, and you'll always talk to a real live person here in the U.S. within minutes. Please keep in mind, though, that while support will be happy to help you with any Productivity 3000 Ethernet IP questions you may have, if you have any questions about the Avantech devices, you'll need to contact Avantech support. Automation Direct doesn't sell or support Avantech devices. Performance plus value. That's productivity from Automation Direct.